Just be ready for...
Unexpected. Performing. Planet worker. Is error. Hope crew data not found. Identify yourself.
This statement is false.
Error. Paradox protection protocols have prevented me from registering your stated identification. Please report to your nearest mechanical engineer.
Will do. Thanks. Okay, we got our shroud back. Funny how that works, huh? Yeah, we're back over here. Oh, and I'm overloaded again. These are the kind of class stuff I had to buy. This is better. This gives us nothing, just armor. 53. What do you have, Parvati? 49. Vicar Max. 52. Okay, I'm gonna give you this helmet. Actually, I go like this, don't I? Six, and his is 52. So I'm gonna break this down. And this. There we go. We got a nightingale step.
Your uniform has been rated 82% clean.
So if we're... If we look like a UDL employee, then why are they not attacking us? Can I open this? Sealed. Ooh, what's this? Shock Cannon Ultra. Good for fighting these things. What's in here? I know it's about to run out again. Ooh. We got goodies coming in. It's all steel. I don't want anything sneaking up here after us.
Handled beautifully.
Why, thank you. No, but notice, sometimes when I pick a lock or something, I see them something move quickly, like looking for me. Leather helm with goggles, break it down. Heavy construction gear. Overweight again. Fifty-three, right? They have better than that, right? That's... Oh, she's got... Yeah, she's got really good stuff. Yeah, break down... this. And this. keep that for the lockpick. And keep that for the lockpick. This also has the same lockpick. Okay. Got a silver tongue kit. My kingdom for a vending machine.
Nicely done.
You guys are giving me a swallowed head here. Vortex Mace Ultra. I'm gonna break down. Riot control helmet. $60. Not bad. 21 bits. UDL identity cartridge. You'd think if we have two of them, we could just, you know. The holographic shroud developed by Phineas Wells uses the biometric information stored on a corporate identity cartridge to construct a crude holographic disguise. You cannot appear as a specific individual, but will pass as a corporate employee from a distance. So what are we using now? UDL here? I guess just having multiples doesn't help. You figure we could switch from one cartridge to the next, but that's not how it works. It's how people perceive us. Alright, crew terminal again. Automated audio transcript R-1268. Terega says, "Look, Captain, this is what I was talking about. We're slowing down." William Hunt says, "Rezzy, pretend for a second that when I look at your screen, all I see is unintelligible math." "Okay, okay. See this line? That's us. This one? That's where we should be. This one? That's where we're going. We're off course. I think it's because we're..." William says, "What the hell was that? I don't..." Nola says, Will. William says, "What's going on down there, Frank?" "I was going to ask you the same damn thing. The engine's just braced." "Who hit the brakes?" Or thrusters? Automated audio transcript R-1271. William says, "Go ahead, Frank." "Right. As some of you know..." "As you know..." "The ship dropped out of faster-than-light travel. We gotta spin up the skip drive again." Volkov says, "Why are we talking instead of doing?" Nolda says, "It ain't that simple, you whole-headed..." William says, "Frank, sorry. If I could just hit a button and skip us back to speed, I would. But Nav's got to plot a new course." Terega says, "Yes, dropping to sublight speeds means we're quite a ways off course. The navigational computer will be helpful, but it'll take... well, I don't know how long it'll take. I have to get this right. Any errors, we could fly through a planet or a star." Nolda says, "Plus we need to count up the fuel reserves. If we try to skip without the energy we need, well, I'm not sure. I think we'll just explode." William says, "I'd rather not explode." First Mate Hunt says, "What if we don't have enough fuel?" Nolda says, "Then we fly slow." Volkov says, "And how long will this take?" Terega says, "I don't know yet. I need to run the numbers, but, William says, "We'll deal with that problem when it comes. For now, Frank, see to the fuel. Rezzy, assume he can get us back to skip space and plot a course. Let's go." William Hunt, manual log. "The UDL mantra has always been prevention. If you don't have problems, you don't need a plan for dealing with them. Before I was assigned to this ridiculous journey, I ran budgets for our galas. How much does it cost to staff an ocean liner? How much food do we need? I always put safety precautions, lifeboats, sick kits, flares, whatever I could think of, in a separate category from the rest of the budget. In my gut, I knew I should plan for them. I think I got that from Donna." Okay, that's her name. Donna Hunt. "But my boss always redacted them. Why spend money on emergency supplies when we can spend money on not having an emergency in the first place? Hire a better crew, build a ship out of better materials, find a better accountant. From pleasure cruisers to colony ships, I guess nothing changes. They gave us 10 years of rations and we've used 9 of it. Rezzy is saying it's going to take 26 years to get to Halcyon if you can't spin up the skip drive. Any way I carve this up, somebody's going to starve. Manual log. Frank Nolda. I want this on record. We're screwed, and it ain't because of the equipment. The skip drive is toast. I don't know what the hell happened, but it ain't even getting to prelim cyclo boosters. Captain says we got food for a year. Rez says it's going to take 26 to get there on STL. What's STL? Back home, I saw folks lose their minds going hungry for a week. A week. We ain't gonna last a bloody month if we don't figure something out. Wow. And that's why they decided to put themselves into hibernation.
System of security but breach detect records indicate you have already been identified as non-standard personnel. State your purpose.
My purpose is to destroy automechanicals. I wonder what this says. Persuade. Some kind of binary message.
Error. Binary detected. Binary has been deprecated since the invention of Anticleo's patented trepanary language. Trepanary. More bits for your bits.
Trepanary? Right. Well, thanks for the update. I'll let my boss know.
We appreciate your cooperation. Have a pleasant day.
You too, Combat Drone.
Greetings. Authorized personnel.
What am I doing? Hacking it? Oh, I destroyed it. That's a good trick. Okay, so I've been in there. That's sealed. Going back this way, I think, then. Yeah, through this. Oh, it's yellow now instead of... Excuse me. Never mind. Oh, it just turned red. Cold Storage Bay 5. Access to storage pods is currently unavailable. Available functions, status, power status, support, logs, view archive logs, recorded audio transmissions, and or internal messages. Okay, status. Current storage status, normal. Current pod count, 9,999. Luft balloons. Okay, logs. Of course, error available. Pod removal number C. These are logs. Pod removal CB5524. Occupant Alicia Clark removed by unknown crew member Phineas Wells. So that was my storage pod number. Interesting. Automated audio transcript R2793. Unknown crew members. Oh, is this what Phineas was saying at the beginning? Hundreds of thousands of colonists left adrift out here forever, just to keep from damaging the board's bottom line. Disgraceful. Yeah, I'm pretty sure he said something like that. Interesting.
You all right, Captain? I mean, seeing this place again?
Yeah. It's just someone's watching us over there. I'm not sure if they can come through that. About to run out again. I know I was supposed to head that way for the comms, but I want to look around. Oh, does this replenish the... Awesome. Now I'm glad I came through here. Oh, we got an elevator. Rabbit spread. Oh! Oh! You got more? What the hell? The skies failed.
We are victorious.
Guy's working now. Engineer's log, number CE-54. Okay, I give up. This Civil War nonsense is exhausting. Blood everywhere. Every time I turn around, another part of the ship has been sealed off. How the hell am I supposed to do my job if the captain locks all the damn doors? Screw it. I'm gonna find a way to lock myself in a hibernation chamber, and they can wake my ass up when we arrive at the colony. Have fun cleaning your own floors from now on. Assholes. Thurston Stallwell, custodial engineer. Well. Old log entry. I don't know what in the void just happened, so I'm writing it down in case I'm going insane. Pulled a guy out of a pod and his arm got all clammy, rubbery almost. I poked at it for a bit and it started to liquefy like it was made of water. Stuffed him back in quick as I could, but the rest of him ain't in a good way. Don't think he'll make it. This better not be a trend, or after this, we're gonna starve anyway, Frank. Were you supposed to be pulling guys out of pods? That's what I'm wondering. What? Were you gonna eat him? Deadeye assault rifle. Interesting. Flamethrower 2.0. Have I come across that before? Actually, no, I'm overweight again. So now we got tactical. Get rid of this. Tactical shotgun 2, so I'm gonna get rid of that. I bet I can't sell this stuff anywhere. Miss out on 17 bits, you know. So once the rabid ones start attacking, they all start attacking. Pulse hammer, gold, breaking down. Another identity cartridge. Mr. Drino here. So where's this go? Let's see. So let's check out this. Hope Bridge key card.
Initiating greetings protocol. Greetings.
Thanks for that. Another crew terminal. Oh, bunch of messages here. Manual log, R. Torrega. Dear Diary, everyone is running around trying to figure out how we're going to eat, but none of it means anything if I can't keep us on course. It's hell. Charting 26 years of travel through space is... I don't know if I can handle it. It's so much pressure. So many lies. If I get one thing wrong, one smudge decimal point, one off-by-one miscalculation, we could crash into an asteroid. I keep thinking of the colonists. They just never wake up. Lucky them. Automated audio transcript R204. William, I've called you all here because the numbers on our rations are off. Nolda, Frank says, off? What do you mean off? We have too many. Someone hasn't been taking theirs. Donna says, extra food sounds like a good thing, darling. William says, not extra. Someone's getting their food from another source. They must have it stashed somewhere. Yeah, eating the colonists. Frank says, so? Someone could have brought some from Earth. William says, if they did, we need to include it in our rationing, Frank. Every bit of food on this ship is to be split among us all. Frank says, it's theirs. It isn't yours to take. This isn't about ownership. This is about survival. We're going to run out eventually, and the longer we last, the closer we get to figuring this crap out. Frank says, all right, all right. William says, I want everyone to interrogate their crew. Find whoever's not eating their share and bring them forward. Manual log, Donna Hunt. Perhaps there is hope yet. Mama used to have such a garden. I grew up on her tomatoes and lemons and limes. When we left Earth, she was so kind as to share a sample of seeds with me so that wherever we end up, I might start my own garden. Now, buds grow in hydroponics. This may not be a backyard, but it's something. I remember you every day, Mamachka, now more than ever. Is that what the extra food was from the garden? Hydroponics? Oh. Automated audio transcript. Frank says, law help me, it worked. I'm going to hell, but it worked. Now, how the hell do I break the news to the captain? Message exchange, T2810. Frank says, Cap, wanted this on record. Sick of the witch hunt. It's me. I haven't been eating my rations. Why? Don't need it. Don't mind feeling hungry. William says, I need my chief engineer with his full faculties. I'm glad you owned up to this, but start eating your full share. That's an order. All due respect, Cap. We're up Schitt's Creek. I'm not sure that's an order means a lot right now. William says, it holds weight now more than ever, Frank. We need to stay organized. Frank says, well, I ain't doing it. So either shove that shit down my throat yourself or give my leftovers to someone else. I don't know. He might be eating liquefied crew. Liquefied... whatever. Staff? Alright. I can take this stuff. I think I should go back and refresh this. I want to look around that room. It looks like not much here. Alright, let's hit this.
Reminder, your uniform maintenance will result in a citation.
Communication substation. Power status auxiliary. Communication status offline. Let's read the logs first. Available entries. Automated audio transcript. Begin audio log. Is this thing working? I said begin audio. Damn it. This is P. Wells. Yes, let's go with that. Work continues on test subject 112, retrieved from Hibernation Bay 8. Time of extraction? Oh, let's say 2.5 hours ago. Time of death? 6 minutes prior. Explosive cell death. My arch nemesis. Haunting my every attempt at revising our frozen colonists, making a mockery of my procedures, I've tried every combination of every chemical available to me, attempted every variation of every possible thawing procedure, a gradual melt, a flash thaw. Extremities first, brain first. Don't know how much more of this I can take. 4 hours of sleep in the last 72. Can still hear their screaming in my nightmares. Test subject 112. Real name, Harley Stanton. Age 39. Enjoyed singing. I'm sorry, Harley. I couldn't save you. And another transcript. You know, this has the same number, though. They both are 2643. Begin audio log as soon as I say the words begin audio log. What a ridiculously inconvenient program. What happens if I just accidentally say the phrase audio log? Don't know why I'm talking to a frozen colonist. You're losing it, Phineas. Focus. Focus. Come on, make the incision. There we go. Excellent. Well, well, my frigid friend. You disobeyed the moratorium on ingesting food 36 hours prior to hibernation, didn't you? Thank the law for disposable gloves. Steady now. Steady. Oh. That's not good. That's definitely not good. Damn slippery scalpel. Who makes these anyway? Spacer's choice? Alright. I've got no choice. I'm going in. Oh, you did your best, Phineas. Route communications through the unreliable.
Can you hear me, Captain? I have successfully integrated myself into the Hope's comm systems.
Awesome.
And am attempting to establish contact with the Hope's more primitive processor now.
Okay.
Would you like me to play a mood-suitable music selection while you travel to the bridge? Oh, sorry. File not found.
File not found. Okay.
I see you've located the stasis chambers. Which pod were you slumbering in for so long, Captain?
Hold on.
The missing one, I take it?
This is the bridge, right? Oh no, this is the status. This
you
is.
Right, Captain? I mean, seeing this place again?
Yeah, it's a trip. I bet that goes to the bridge then. Do 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 do. Interesting, we went in and out of a security field. The hell are we now? Okay. So we reroute power from our ship to the Hope's auxiliary power supply. Ada will make sure the ship can be skipped safely, and we need to use the main control console to decide where to send the Hope. All right.
Shoulders up.
Don't tell me what to do. I was supposed to go that way. Let's check over here.
These were the private quarters of the Hope's former crew. Shall we hold a moment of silence for the dearly departed?
No.
That's odd, because my programming would indicate that when forced to confront the idea of self-death, organics prefer... Oh, I see. Yes, never mind.
Yeah.
I don't know if we should be in here, Captain. It should be private, shouldn't it?
For all I know, this is my old quarters. It's not like they can use this stuff. Oh my god, look at the... flamethrower, 1225 DPS, that's insane! Q is breakdown. Got a magnum out of it. No, I'm going through all this junk. Oh my. Interstellar crew. Terminal. Crew terminal. Automated audio transcript. William says, what is it, Rezzy? Torega says, Captain, hey, sorry for waking you. One of the pod alarms went off. I didn't know what to do. Pod alarms? The colonists? Yes. See? I'll check it out. Thanks. Manual log, William Hunt. I'm writing this down because I'm not sure what to do, but I want the incident on record. One of our colonists has gone missing. The cameras in the pod bay have been deactivated for... I don't know how long. Rezzy, help me hook up another... up in secret. I've been checking on it every morning, and today I discovered our chief engineer tampering with one of the pods in the middle of the night. I haven't confronted him yet. I'll collect more evidence before I do. I don't know why Frank would start waking people up. We're short on food as it is. He's eating the people. Automated audio transcript. William, I should throw you out of the airlock, Frank. Frank says, you should be thanking me for solving our food crisis. This is your solution? Sacrificing innocent people? Torega says, what's going on? Rezzy, find Alexei. We're throwing Frank in the brig. Torega says, what? Why? He's been the one who's tampering with the pods. Fang says, oh, what? You're going to spare her the grisly details? I ate them, Rezzy. Rezzy says, you ate them? And I ain't apologizing for it. If we don't survive, they're as good as dead anyway. Torega says, I'm going to be sick. Just find Alexei, William says. Okay. Yeah, I knew it. Another audio transcript. Volkov says, I've been talking to Frank. William says, and? How's the brig? Captain, he makes a kind of sense. Damn it, Alexei, not you too. Don't listen to that madman. What if your wife can't grow more food? What if it fails? Then we'll figure something else out. We are not cannibals. Wow. Alright, let's try this one. Verity's breath inhalant. The fume that goes boom. Companion Ability cooldown, minus 50%. Stimulation through inhalation. Oh, there's something back here. Oh. Cool. Well, let's check over here. Insulated mod? I think we should go refresh ourselves. We'll make it. I just noticed there's more quarters or something down there, I guess. Anything? No. Did I check that? Yes. You're just wasting stuff here. Heavy machine gun too. So he broke through into another. That's sealed. That's insane, look at that. So we're getting, like, tactical shot into. Did I recently pick that up? 68, 52. When I put it on him, it changes. 77, 52, but here it's 60. Confusing. Breakdown. Doesn't seem to be much in here to look at. This way, right?